When we entered Germany in September of 44, Eisenhower issued a directive to take possession of Nazi Party records. My name is Greg Bradshaw, and I'm a senior archivist at the National Archives at College Park, Maryland. The office of the chief prosecutor for the United States sent his staff all over Germany looking for things that could provide evidence to be submitted.
Attention! Tribunal!
At the Nuremberg trials.
My name is Steve Koblick. I'm president of the Huntington Library Art Collections and Botanical Gardens, which is in San Marino, California. The documents that we're talking about have been known almost from the beginning as in their popular name, which is the Nuremberg Laws. Once they were passed in the fall of 1935 by the German Reichstag and signed by the Chancellor Adolf Hitler, anyone who was Jewish could no longer be considered German and could no longer be considered a part of the German state. The documents were brought to the Huntington by General George S. Patton, Jr. In June of 1945.
General Patton was not a lot different from a lot of soldiers who picked up souvenirs in Germany. Everyone wanted something.
There were instructions to General Patton at the time that documents related to persecution of the Jews should be sent to a common collecting area in Germany. The general chose not to follow those instructions. General Patton was on leave from his command of the Third Army. The war in Europe was over, and he was visiting his family, which resided next to the Huntington. He gave an envelope to the then librarian and asked him to keep these documents in the Huntington vaults. He went to Europe and unfortunately was killed later in the same year. So the Huntington had these documents.
I hold in my hand the document book that will be submitted to this tribunal.
What the prosecutors ended up using in lieu of the original Nuremberg Laws was the a photostat rather than the original. They didn't know that Patton had earlier that year taken it back with him to California.
All photostatic copies are true and correct copies of the originals.
This is page 2 of the most famous of the Nuremberg Laws. It does not define what or who is a Jew. Nonetheless, it forbids normal intercourse between Germans and Jews, and that's really the purpose of the law.
In 1947, the hundreds and actually thousands of boxes that were accumulated by the prosecutor's office came to the National Archives, and this is the box from which the printed copy of the Nuremberg Laws is contained in today.
They're being transferred to the National Archives because the National Archives would have been where the documents were had General Patton actually followed General Eisenhower's orders.
The original is basically coming to us 63 years late, but we're happy to be getting it now, although I'm sure the prosecutors would have liked to have had it back in 1945 for the trial.